Binance is one of the easiest and safest ways to buy cryptocurrencies. If you're new to crypto and want to get your feet wet by purchasing some Dogecoin, Bitcoin, or other altcoins, then Binance may be a great option for you. I will show you step by step how to buy Dogecoin on Binance in this beginner-friendly tutorial. Then later in the video, I will guide you through the more advanced way of buying your crypto. It is a little bit more difficult, but is well worth your time mastering because they have much lower trading fees and will save you a lot of money in the long run. I've also made a free custom crypto trading calculator for you, which will help keep track of your investments and trading profits. And I will show you how to get access to this later on in the video, so make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get into the video. First, click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It'll take you to the correct Binance sign up page to get you started if you don't have an account yet. And from here, you just have to enter in your email, password, then click create account, pull this slider to the correct position. Now get your verification code from your email. Type that in, and you're all set. Your account is ready to go. And now let's go to their homepage by clicking on go to dashboard. Next, we need to secure our account by adding two-factor authentication. And I'm gonna use Google verification instead of the phone verification here. Click on that. And now we just follow the steps provided by Binance. Either download the app from the App Store or Google Play. And now we scan the QR code. Click next again. Now click here to get the code. So it will be sent to your email address. Type that code in from your email and then type in your new code from your Google authentication and click submit. And once you've done that, you're ready to go and purchase your Bitcoin. And there are two ways of doing this, the easier way, which has higher fees, or the harder way, which has less fees. So I'll show you the first way, which is the easier way, and that is using your credit or debit card. And you can do this by going to Buy Crypto and click on credit/debit card. It'll take you to this page where you can input the currency that you want to sell and the currency that you want to buy. So in this example, we want to buy Dogecoin, right? So you click on here and type in Doge, select that. And now I want to say $100. And now I press on continue. And now we can add our credit card information. And if you're happy with everything, you can click on continue. It will now come up with a summary showing you the price of Doge, how many you will receive, and what the fees are. And if you're ready to go ahead, you just click on confirm here. And that's it. That's how easy it is to buy Dogecoin with your credit or debit card. But as I said to you from the beginning, this is the easiest method, but it's going to cost you a lot in fees, right? You can see here, there's already a 2% fees, and it can go up as high as 3.5% here using your credit or debit card. So even though it's more convenient using this method, it's going to cost you a lot more. So this is why I recommend you choose the second option if you're not in such a rush, as it will take a bit of time for the money to arrive into your account, but you're going to save a lot on fees. So it's up to you whether time is more important or you want to cut down on your costs. Now with this second method, the fees can be as cheap as 0.075%. If you use the BNB coin to pay your fees, you'll get a 25% discount, and this means your fees are about 4 times lower than the first method. Here's a quick question for you. What percentage of your portfolio do you plan on holding in Dogecoin, and why? Let me know in the comments section below. So what you need to do here is go to Buy Crypto and click on Bank Deposit. And now you want to select the currency that you're using. It may be the Australian dollars, euro, pounds, or US dollars. So you can see here that the transfer will cost $0 in fees. So all you're doing is depositing money into your bank account. So click on continue, type in your amount, click continue again, click on confirm. And you can see here, this is the information you will need to provide in your bank transfer. So you need to log into your actual bank account, input this information, put in the right dollar amount that you're going to transfer to Binance, and then send the funds through. So you can see here, it can take between 2 to 4 business days to make the transfer. So even though you're not paying any fees, it's going to take a couple more days. So you need to have a bit of patience using this method. So now let's say our deposit has come through. We're now ready to trade our dollars into Dogecoin. And what you do is go to trade and just simply click on convert. It'll bring you to this page again where you will choose the currency you want to change from and to. So from here will be BUSD in this example, because the US dollars that you transfer in will be automatically converted into BUSD. So click on that, and the two account is Doge. We want to buy Doge, right? So we type in Doge and click here. And let's say I want to do $100 again, and we can click on preview, or you can type in the amount of Doge you want instead. Let's say I want 1000 Doge. You can now click on preview and see how much that is in terms of US dollars. So we can see here, the summary shows us the price and how much you'll actually spend to get 1000 Doge, okay? And if you're happy with that, click on refresh one more time and then click on convert, and you will have successfully bought your Dogecoin. So that was the easier way of buying your Dogecoin with the second method. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my tutorial so far? If yes, make sure to let me know by liking my video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more high quality content that I'll be releasing every single week. But if you want a bit more control and set a buy order below the current price or set some future sell orders above the price, then you'll need to use the advanced method. And that method can be accessed from going to trade and clicking on advanced. And now it'll bring you to this more complicated looking dashboard where you can see the candlesticks on the left side and the price action up here, and also all the boxes where you can input buy and sell orders on the right hand side. So first of all, we want to click on this arrow button and then type in Doge. And this will bring up all the trading pairs that you're allowed to make with Dogecoin. So like I said before, if you're depositing US dollars, you can use BUSD, but if you have other currencies that you deposited, like the Euro or Australian dollars, you can choose those pairs instead. In this case, I'll choose the BUSD, click on that, and this is our Doge trading pair. And you can see here, there's a limit, market, and stop limit type orders. I'm only going to talk about the market orders for now, but if you want more information on how to set proper limit and stop limit orders, I have a full tutorial here that you can go to and follow along for that. But if we want to buy, you click here. If you want to sell, click here. So right now I want to buy at market. So that means it's going to buy Doge for you at the current market price that's on the order book here. So let's say I want to buy $100 worth of Doge. All you have to do then is click on buy Doge here. This is essentially the same method as clicking on trade and convert like I showed you previously. But as you can see, you have more control to decide on when you want to buy, because you can go to the charts and look deeper into it, or even go to the trading view and start doing a bit more of a technical analysis before you purchase. And like I said, you can set limit orders to buy the dip and set sell orders to take profit also. So it's up to you between these 2.5 methods on which one you like the most. For me, I always transfer money through my bank account into Binance, and then I use this advanced trading method to buy and sell my coins. And once you've bought Doge, it should come up here in your available balance. And if you want my free custom crypto trading calculator, then just go to this link in the description below to get access to that. Once you have your Dogecoin, I recommend you transfer it into your own crypto wallet, which you own the keys to. Even though holding your cryptocurrencies on Binance or any other crypto exchange is a cheap and easy way of storing your crypto, I do not recommend you do this. So if Binance get hacked, your assets will be all gone, as you don't own the keys to these wallets. Binance do. So this is very important. And there's two types of crypto wallet which I recommend you create. One is free and one is paid. Obviously the free option is easier to start, but the paid option is the best way. So the free wallet I recommend is using Trust Wallet. This is created by Binance themselves, and you can use them as your crypto wallet. You own the keys, so they are your own wallet. The upside to this choice is that it's free, but the downside is that it's always going to be on your phone and connected to the internet. So it's essentially an online wallet which can be hacked at any time. So it's not as safe. But in saying that, but if you only plan on investing $100 or $200 or any other lower amount, then I think this option is perfect for you. But if you want to invest anything more than $1,000, then I recommend the second choice, which is to get a hardware wallet. And these are offline hardware wallets. They're like a USB dongle, which you can plug into your computer and connect your wallet online. So this means that if it's not plugged in, you technically have no chance of getting hacked, unless your private keys have been stolen. But if you don't have your private keys online anywhere either, then this is the safest option. And this is what I use myself. And there are some good hardware options here, like the Trezor wallet or the Ledger wallet. And I have a full in-depth tutorial on my channel about which are the best mobile wallets and hardware wallets you should consider. So check that out if you want more information about it. So if you're ready to proceed with Binance and want to know the next step to take, then I recommend you go to this video. However, if you're not happy with Binance Exchange and want an alternative, then this is the one I would recommend. So check it out and I'll see you over there.